Hey everyone, it's Amy, and today I want to go through some really great uses for fennel. So fennel is 10% off today. I mean, it's 10% off this month for June. So if you don't already have fennel, it's definitely a good month to get it because it is 10% off. So one way, major way to use it is digestion. So funny story, this morning Ray woke up and he's like, "Oh, my stomach hurts." And he's just complaining. You know how guys are, like when they're sick, they're like the worst, the biggest babies in the world. So I'm like, go to my office and get, well, come to my office here and get oils. And he's like, no, I don't want it. I'm like, okay. So I just grab, I grab fennel, peppermint, ginger, and digestion. And I just said, pick one and rub it on your stomach. So this is really good for healthy digestion. So if you have a stomach ache or if you just want to keep things, like if you know you're prone to stomach aches or bloating or just whatever the case may be for digestion, having fennel and just eat before your meal, you rub a couple of drops, anywhere from 1 to 2 drops, and then you can reapply if you don't feel any effects from it in 20 minutes. Side note from that, so less is always better. So less more often is better than more and less often, if that makes sense. So let's say you have a stomach ache. Unless it's like really bad, like you have like chronic diarrhea, it's better to put 1, 2, 3 drops and wait 15, 20 minutes. And if it doesn't go away, put a little bit more than to put like 12 drops on and then you know, wait however long it takes, because honestly, the 2 to 3 drops probably would have worked just as well. So fennel is one of those great oils for digestion. So another good way to use this is for sweet cravings. So we all have sweet tooth, especially me. So you can do a couple of things with this. You can make a tea. Again, you have to like the taste of fennel if you're going to do that. Some people love it, but you can always make a tea with any oil that you can ingest. You can make tea with. So I've made like On Guard tea, lemon tea. What's another one I've made? Ginger is a good one for tea, which is also good for digestion. So just depends on if you like it. So fennel is another one. If you don't like the taste of fennel, put it in a capsule. If you know you're prone to having sweet cravings and you have a really bad sweet tooth, put these in a capsule, 1 to 2 drops, and boom, you're ready to go. With the capsules though, because the oils are so potent, make sure you're making the capsule right when you're gonna take it. You can't make a bunch and then kind of leave them around and you'll come back to a puddle of oils. So don't do that. Another good way is for menstrual cramps. So you can rub this on your ovaries. Just put, again, 2 to 3 drops, rub it on your ovaries, and it can help with menstrual cramps. Another way is fluid retention. So you know how sometimes you just feel like your ankles are swollen or you just feel like bloated in different parts of your body? Mixing fennel with grapefruit and rubbing it on either the area or taking it internally, whichever one you choose, will definitely help flush out that extra water in your body that you don't need. And one that's really, really helpful, the last one way I'm going to go through, that most of us honestly can't even use it, but you may know somebody that needs it, is helping milk production when you're breastfeeding. So taking 1 to 2 drops and rubbing it on your actual breast will help increase milk production. So again, I know that's not something that any of us, or most of us, aren't even dealing with. I think there's only one of you guys that's actually breastfeeding. But like I said, you might know somebody, and it's a common problem for a lot of people that are breastfeeding. So this will increase it by literally in 24 to 48 hours, which is huge. If some of you guys I know have breastfed in the past, and if your milk production goes down, like that's like your baby's food source. So it's a huge problem. So those are some really good ways to use fennel. Don't discount it just because you may not like the smell or the taste. It is a still very beneficial oil, and you don't ever have to smell it. Like I've never used this in a diffuser blend because I don't like the smell, I'll be honest. But I do take it internally. I do sometimes have like major sweet cravings, and I'll take this in a capsule. So that's it for today, and I'll talk to you next time.